Hey, what's up, guys? This is Zachary Adkins, and today we are going to be checking out the song Square Hammer by Ghost. Ghost gets a little bit of a bad rap. I'm not really sure why. I wonder if it's like because of the gimmick or whatnot, but I don't know. I actually think that they're pretty good. And by they, I pretty much just mean Tobias, right? Because he's the one that does everything. So basically what I want to do is I just listen to the song, talk about what I like, what I don't like, what I think of the mix, what I think of, the actual songwriting or what I believe they were going for, just like an overall analysis of the song. So anyway, hope you guys like it. And if you do, hit that subscribe button and also like the video. That just helps the YouTube algorithm kind of, it just helps me out. So that'd be really appreciated. I might say some funny stuff and I might not. I don't know. It depends on how I feel and what I think about the song. But we're going to watch the video too. So this is definitely going to get flagged, meaning that I won't make any monetization off of this video at all. So if you could, consider joining over at my Patreon page. Basically, I got a bunch of tiers over there. And, you get some really cool perks over there. It's just a way to help support me on the channel here. I would really appreciate it. So consider doing that. And let's get right to the video. Okay, well, first and foremost, I love the imagery already. Like this right here, this kind of stuff, like the, move myself a little bit. So, like, the imagery here of the logo, it almost reminds me of like, Kiss, right? So, I wonder if that's why a lot of people don't really like Ghost, is because it kind of reminds them of Kiss, and if you like Kiss, then you're lame, which you're not lame, because Kiss fucking rules. But I think even in an interview that I watched, he talked about like Kiss being one of his favorite bands. Tobias, like, you know, he really tried to emulate it. I mean, it's a show, man. I mean, if you're gonna pay $50 to go see a show, you want some cool shit. So, or more $50. I don't even know how much they charge for a show. No idea. But really cool. I love the imagery. I kind of like this old like horror movie type feel. It's kind of cool. Got this kind of popping up here, and then this. I don't even know what you'd call that. I'm not a graphic artist, but I just like the way that this looks. It's kind of cool. It's kind of weird. So anyway, sorry. We're just going to continue. I'll shut the hell up. So before it kicks in, you can actually tell when they were recording on my right ear here, that's where the main riff is coming through. And then you hear, you know, like, so look at it like this big spectrum of space here, right? Between your ears, like, so you're getting most of that guitar here. Over here, there's really not much going on. You can hear the drums, you can hear some of the synth and stuff going on, but you start hearing that feedback on the left side, that kind of whirring sound. And again, you kind of have to have at least decent headphones on to hear that, where you can hear the spatial differences. But I love stuff like that, okay, because it really just adds to the whole atmosphere. Because if you're watching them on stage, let's say, and you've got the guitar player over here and the guitar player over here, I guarantee you that this guy's playing that riff. So when you're watching them, you're hearing it on that right-hand side like you would on the album. And then this guy starts doing some feedback and whatnot too, which is really, really great. Okay? So another thing to think about is how much of a cool buildup that is, because it's the same riff repeated over and over again. Four times, right? To kind of help build that difference between riff A, you know, you got the drums coming in, and then both of them come in and you just get this wall of sound. So listen up for that if you're listening with headphones anyway. So you kind of hear just the whirring of the guitar and then a big wall of sound when the riff kicks in. So hopefully you kind of felt that, right? It just punches you in the head, which is nice. Again, I love the imagery on this music video. I'm kind of like staring at it and just like getting dumb. So it's super cool. Let's keep watching. I don't really know what the theme is of the music video, but I just love this song, man. I do know I've watched videos where they do that, where he says that asunder, and it like has that. Everybody on the stage like they kick the stage and just kind of make, they make a big freaking deal out of it. It's really smart, man, like, because then everybody gets into it. Now, of course, another thing to think about with the, with like a mix or something like that, is you don't want to always just be overloading people with noise and sounds and guitars and everything. When you're trying to have something cut through, right, like the vocals in this case, a lot of times they dial that guitar back a little bit. So that's why they're doing some palm mutes. They're creating a little bit of overhead so that way the vocals can come in and actually stand out. So they're not trying to fight or compete with that frequency, which is great. And you know, I know a lot of people give him crap about his voice, but I like it, man. Like, it just fits the overall vibe of the tune. And I think that he does need a little bit of work. Not, I mean, his singing is fine, but you could tell they've added a lot of stuff to his vocals. You know, a lot of reverb, a lot of just stuff to help boost that up, which is fine. I don't have anything against that, because it's, I mean, you, if you're going to come out with millions of dollars to get a friggin' album sounding amazing, I don't know if they actually spent that much, but you know, if you're going to come out with all that kind of money to make an album sound good, then it has to sound amazing, and you don't want to skimp on that. So anyway, just a side note, while you're right, you know, for songwriting purposes, dial back sometimes. It's okay to not go like all the way super heavy all the time. Dial back, create some headspace, so that way the guitar solos or vocals or synth or whatever is going to... Now, before the actual whatever chorus kicks in, I love that Ghost has these little like stories, these little, you know, like even on the side here, it's kind of just like everything was so well thought of. It's just weird, you know, like everything he thinks of and all of the imagery and all of like these telling a story about, you know, what's going on in this. I don't know. I just love it. That's the kind of stuff that I like, man. Like, again, just like Kiss, right? They're telling a story with whatever it is that they're doing, or they have the imagery. There's something going on that, that it piques people's interest. So I really like it, man. What a catchy fucking chorus. Catchy. Just catchy as shit. And then you notice, I'm going to back up a little bit here, when they come into this chorus, just like, remember we talked about creating that headspace, getting the palm mutes going, backing off on everything. Right when this chorus kicks in, it's just, you hear the bass and it's so heavy. Everything just punches. And then you don't have to create so much headspace because everything comes in to just kick it. Just like feel that. So hopefully you can feel like it's just like bow, 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 bow. Whatever. Anyway, I'll shut the hell up. So let's see. And then there's like some story going on here. They're like at a movie theater. It's like a movie that they created or some shit. I don't know. The difference in this verse that I'm hearing is there's a little more piano that sounds more prominent, right? It's like they've added that extra chunk of piano in there. Maybe I'm mishearing that. I don't really want to go back and listen, but at least that's what I'm capturing at this point. And there's something weird going on with this video. I don't fucking understand. I do know that like Tobias is, I want to say he's either like a Satanist or like a Mason or something. I'm not really sure what he, Freemasonry. I don't know what he is. I don't know what he believes, what he doesn't believe, but the imagery is still cool. Well, that was fucking sweet. It's crazy. I don't understand what's going on. Like, I'm kind of seeing, like, this guy, like, grabs some hammer, square hammer, I assume. and then this Papa Emeritus, I think, Emeritus, like, he, like, casts a spell or something, and then he's, like, able to jump out of the movie screen, I guess, because he's so powerful, and then these guys are freaking out about something, and then he turns into a popsicle thing, and then he jumps, and now he's a bat, or a bunch of bats, and this is the worst explanation of anything ever in the entire world. I'll say this, though. Bias. You're not watching this video because I'm not important, but if you ever did, for whatever reason, hire me to play some solos for this album, dude. You don't even have to pay me. I'll just write some kick-ass solos over those riffs. Let me do it. Alright, anyway, we're back to the moon or something. Oh, that was sick. Like, just, like, the fact that he thought to, like, that big punch comes in and then this guy does a little fucking vampire thing. I don't know. He's not a vampire. What is that about, like, the Red Cardinal? There's something about Red Cardinals and masonry or something like that. There's a lot of weird imagery in here, and I'm not smart enough to figure it out. But I could say during this little part here, just because it visually made me... I don't even know what I'm trying to say. But there was, like, something weird going on with the guitars here. They, like, added something. I felt... I heard it over here in the right ear that they added some other different guitar element, which is kind of cool. Let's keep going. There's that Cardinal. I don't know. Somebody write in the comments what the fuck that's about. You know, I don't think I could be in Ghost. Look at how skinny these guys are. I'm like fat as shit. Like, I wouldn't even look cool in the outfit. I'd look like a fat penguin or something. Not sure what any of that meant. But that was kind of cool. It's interesting. Oh yeah, that song rules too. Anyway, well... That's a really crappy analysis of that song and me just making stupid commentary. So if you like the video, give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button. Yeah, also leave me a comment about what song you want me to do next. I'm going to do a whole bunch of these and just have some fun with it. So anyway, all right, guys, we'll see you in the next video. Also consider subscribing to my Patreon.